Now for the analysis. Mostly, I'll just try to share the intuition. We want to show that order E times V augmentations are used. To see this, we define something called a level graph. The level of a vertex is defined to be the shortest path distance from the source vertex S. The level graph, then, is a subgraph of the original that includes only those edges from one level to a level that's one higher. For example, if this were my directed graph here, then the level graph would be this subgraph down here. Here, these edges here have been deleted because they go between vertices within the same level, and this one has been deleted because it went backwards, or up a level, in the graph. We first observe that augmenting along a shortest path only creates paths that are longer ones. Say that we push flow along this path here. Then we've introduced back edges along this path. Note, however, that these edges are useless for creating a path of the same length. In fact, because they go back up a level, any path that uses one of them must use two more edges than the augmenting path that we just used, the one that was the shortest path. Next, we observe that the shortest path distance must increase every E iterations. Every time that we use an augmenting path, we delete an edge from the level graph, the edge that got saturated. Maybe this one here got saturated in an augmentation along this path, so we would delete that. And then maybe we push another flow along this path and end up deleting this edge. These edges won't come back into the level graph until the minimum path length is increased. As we've already argued, the reverse edges are useless until we are allowed to use longer paths. So if each augmentation deletes one edge from the level graph, then certainly after E iterations, the level graph would be empty. And then clearly there are no ST paths in this level graph, and so we need to build a bigger one that includes longer paths in order to be able to augment any further. And lastly, there are only V possible shortest path lengths, so that completes the theorem. For each possible path length, we might have up to E iterations. Going back to the theorem, note that we've eliminated the dependence of the running time on the capacities. This means that the algorithm is now strongly polynomial, and actually we can eliminate the requirement that the capacities be integers entirely.